Hey Survivor fans, please like, share, and subscribe. Check out my Survivor puzzle app. The link is in the video's description.
39 days, 18 people, one Survivor. Previously on Survivor. 16 Americans were marooned on a remote South Pacific island, each with a story to tell.
I am by far the most survivor-savvy player ever to play the game.
I've won over 20 poker tournaments, and I own 2 medical marijuana dispensaries.
I'm a retired New York City police detective, and I'm openly gay.
And they immediately discovered that they weren't alone.
I'm a little bit nervous to see who it is.
They were joined by 2 former survivors, Coach, who went to Upolu in blue, and Ozzy, who went to Savai in red.
Yeah!
They have so much experience. This is their third time each. They'll be huge assets to us.
But not everyone was thrilled with the new arrivals. Christine even challenged them.
They are temporary players.
Yes!
Ozzy wins for Savai! After Ozzy defeated Coach in a head-to-head battle, Edna became Coach's only friend.
My tribe walks off, and one person stops and helps me.
Back at camp, Coach went to work. He forged a bond with Brandon, and suddenly, he had 2 friends. Still in trouble, he worked his way into a conversation.
I've been a dragon slayer!
And walked away with an alliance of 5, consisting of all 4 men on his tribe and 1 woman, Sophie.
I think I'm sitting pretty right now.
The wild card in his alliance was Brandon, who was struggling with a dangerous secret.
I am Russell Hance's nephew.
I will never tell them my last name.
At Ozzy's tribe, Cochran had no secrets.
I have a buff collection at home.
I have a translucent skin. I try to be a provider. I mean, that's my real purpose in life.
Yes!
Michaela is a scoring machine! Semhar way short! In one of the closest immunity challenges on record. Michaela, that might do it! Coach's tribe squeaked out a win. Upolu wins immunity!
Yes!
Sorry, guys.
At Tribal Council, it came down to the 2 weakest, Semhar and Cochran. But Cochran saved himself by promising to improve.
I'm going to be your genie in a bottle. You don't even have to rub, actually. I'll just come out and do it.
Semhar, the tribe has spoken.
Now Semhar is banished to Redemption Island, and the pressure is on Cochran to make good on his promise before it's too late. Previously on Survivor.
We are now neck and neck.
In the battle between 2 tribes, each with a legendary former player. Upolu wins immunity! Upolu, led by Coach, narrowly won the first immunity challenge. So Ozzy's tribe, Savai, blindsided their weakest player.
Semhar, the tribe has spoken.
And sent her to Redemption Island.
I gave them my every last strength.
Meanwhile, Ozzy strengthened his position in the tribe by finding a hidden immunity idol.
This might be my ticket to the win.
And joining an alliance of 5.
Me, Keith, Ozzy, Elise, and Whitney.
At Upolu, Coach built his own alliance of 5, and Brandon felt so close to Coach that he revealed his secret.
His uncle is my number one nemesis, Russell Hance.
Savai wins immunity! After Upolu lost the second immunity challenge, Coach wanted to get Christine out.
I haven't forgotten what Christine said on day 1. Coach is a temporary player.
But Brandon innately feared Michaela.
I don't trust her. She's got every guy around here wrapped around her finger but me.
So he took a page from his uncle's playbook and spread false rumors to get her out.
I just walked up to Coach and I lied to him. Stacey and Christine told me they're voting out Michaela.
But at Tribal Council, Brandon shocked everyone by confessing his sins.
I told you guys to vote for Michaela.
Michaela, welcome to Survivor.
Who's telling me?
So in the end, Coach got what he wanted.
Christine, the tribe has spoken.
And Christine was sent to Redemption Island.
Well, we're only 5 days into this game, and already the biggest obstacle for this tribe is trust.
16 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on Survivor. At Upolu, Coach thought he'd assembled a solid alliance of 5.
Rick, Sophie, Brandon, and Albert.
And tacked on Edna as a spare 6th while leaving Stacy at the bottom of the pecking order.
I do believe that they are looking to try to get rid of me.
But Brandon started behaving erratically.
My name's Brandon Hance. I'm Russell Hance's nephew.
Blam.
He went against Coach's plan and covertly targeted Michaela.
Michaela will be going home tonight.
Later, he blew up in front of the entire tribe.
I was very upset. Here's evil. period.
Brandon's loose cannon behavior put everyone on edge, especially Coach.
Brandon just worries me.
You're loyal or you're disloyal?
At Savai'i, Ozzy was also in an alliance of five, and he thought he was in charge.
I am the anchor.
Life's good right now.
Keith and Jim made up his core three. Whitney and Elise were his plus two, leaving the oldest and the nerdiest on the chopping block.
I have this reputation as the nervous, neurotic scrambler. I just don't want to go home.
At the immunity challenge, Coach led Upolu to a landslide victory.
Upolu wins immunity!
Sending Savai'i to tribal council, where Papa Bear tried to save himself by steering votes to Cochran.
Physically, he's a threat to himself.
I don't necessarily feel that that's the case.
In the end, Cochran prevailed.
Papa Bear, the tribe has spoken.
Sending Papa Bear to join Christine on Redemption Island, where they will compete in a duel to stay alive. Previously on Survivor.
We are neck and neck in our first immunity challenge.
For the past 17 days, it's been a seesaw battle between two of Survivor's most evenly matched tribes.
This is how close this challenge was. One coconut away.
At Savai'i, Ozzy found a hidden immunity item.
Something good.
And thought he was in control of the dominant alliance.
I am the anchor. They want me to tell them how to do everything.
But one of his allies, Jim, was plotting against him.
So I started thinking, do I make a move against Ozzy?
Jim teamed up with Cochran and Don to undermine Ozzy by targeting his closest confidant, Elise.
If Elise goes first, that buys me another 3 days.
At Upolu, Coach was safe in his alliance.
I think I'm sitting pretty right now.
But not everyone was a Coach fan.
I'm not buying Coach's BS at all.
Stacey was on the chopping block, so she looked in vain for the hidden immunity idol. At the immunity challenge, Dawn, the oldest member of Savai'i, proved she was one of the strongest competitors.
Yes! Stacey drops out of the challenge! Dawn wins for Savai'i!
Upolu went to tribal council, where Brandon, the nephew of the notorious Russell Hance, broke down.
You feel a responsibility to reclaim the family name in a positive light?
I'm gonna do it.
Fourth person voted out of Survivor South Pacific.
In the end, Stacey was voted out, and she passed on a hug from Coach on her way to Redemption Island.
Stacey, the tribe has spoken.
Where she'll soon battle with her old friend, Christine. 14 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on Survivor. By day 14, the two returning players, Ozzy and Coach, were heading in opposite directions. At Upolu, Coach's control over the tribe was growing.
Back in the driver's seat, baby.
He was at the top of an alliance of five and had befriended Edna and added her as his personal sixth.
When it comes to friends, you can never have too many.
At Savai'i, Ozzy's control over the tribe was eroding.
He's becoming the arrogant fisher boy who feels like he can do no wrong and that he's entitled to our deference.
Jim approached Cochran with a plan to undermine Ozzy by getting rid of his closest ally. At the immunity challenge,
Brandon needs to floss. Rick drops one on the ground. Michaela will pick it up.
Upolu narrowly chewed out a win.
Yeah!
Upolu wins immunity and reward. Sending Savai'i to tribal council.
It's all about keeping us as strong as possible.
Ozzy wanted to strengthen the tribe by getting rid of Cochran.
Sorry, man. Hope you get that second chance.
But the rest of the tribe conspired to keep Cochran, and Ozzy was completely surprised by the result.
Elise, the tribe has spoken.
Elise now heads to Redemption Island, where she'll face Christine in a fight for survival. And Ozzy's left to wonder where he stands with his tribe. Previously on Survivor. By day 15, Christine had become a force to be reckoned with.
Christine wins her fourth duel and stays alive on Redemption Island.
And she was dangerously close to winning her way back into the game.
I can do it. I mean, at this far.
At Savai'i, Ozzy was on the outs with his tribe.
I am now a free agent.
But after a big win,
Savai'i wins immunity and reward!
They all kiss and made up.
One, two, three.
Savai'i!
At Upolu, Michaela was the only person not in the Alliance of Six, so Coach wanted her voted out. But Albert and Sophie wanted to get rid of Edna.
Edna has zero challenge value, zero.
At Tribal Council, Brandon erupted, making it the third tribal in a row where he has suffered a meltdown.
Vote me out today,
if we're gonna play disloyal.
But despite the outburst, Michaela was sent to Redemption Island. With both tribes now even and a merge looming, the outcome of the next immunity challenge could change the game. Previously on Survivor.
Go!
On day 17, the Upolu and the Savai tribes were dead even, six each.
Upolu wins!
Savai lost the challenge.
Best team to get in right.
And blamed Cochrane. With the merge looming, Ozzy proposed a risky plan.
I'd be willing to sacrifice myself, go to Redemption, beat Christine and get back in this game and give our tribe an edge.
A tribal council.
I had a dream and I saw my chance at my own redemption.
Ozzy also wanted Cochrane to become a double agent.
I'm gonna make up a story. That Cochrane, the little smart weasel he is, found the idol. We go to vote him out. He whips out the idol. See you later, Ozzy.
And he gave Cochrane his immunity idol for safekeeping.
You hold on to it, and when I get back in the game.
In the end, Savai went along with the plan.
Ozzy, tribe has spoken.
Now the questions are, can Ozzy win at Redemption Island?
Ah, I'm out of here.
Will there be a merge, and can Cochrane become a master spy? Previously on Survivor. On day 19, the two tribes merged.
Drop your buffs.
Yes! Woo! Yes!
And Ozzy returned from Redemption Island and was back in the game.
I'm alive, but at this point, it's a deadlock 6-6 vote.
To get information to break the tie, Cochrane promised to spy on the old Upolu.
Now it's time for me to work my magic, become the double agent, infiltrate Upolu, and change the game.
But Cochrane's espionage career was short-lived when Coach seduced him into actually jumping ship.
Where am I sleeping tonight?
I'm sleeping right between me and Ezra.
At the immunity challenge, there were two winners.
Don and Ozzy safe at tonight's tribal council.
A tribal council.
It's for Whitney.
Ozzy gave his immunity idol to Whitney.
First vote.
But Whitney didn't receive any votes.
We are tied. We're going to revote.
On the revote, Cochrane blindsided Ozzy and his old alliance and voted with the former Upolu tribe.
Coward.
Sending Keith to Redemption Island.
Keith, the tribe has spoken.
Now the former Upolu tribe plus Cochrane have taken over the game.
Well, that was, without question, the biggest move in the game thus far. And this game is far from over.
Previously on Survivor.
Immunity. Yeah. Fight. Congratulations.
For 19 days, two tribes, Upolu and Savai, traded victories in one of the closest battles ever.
Thank you.
When they merged, it was still Upolu versus Savai.
It's 6-on-6, so everybody's looking for an end.
But at the first tribal council after the merge, Cochrane betrayed his old tribe, sending Keith to Redemption Island, giving the old Upolu a numbers advantage, and sending the old Savai into a state of shock.
You throw the whole tribe under the bus. You disgust me.
Jim, safe at tonight's tribal council.
When Ozzy failed to win immunity, the old Upolu jumped at the chance to vote him out.
Let's try this one more time, Jeff.
Ozzy, once again, tribe has spoken.
Sending him to Redemption Island for the second time.
When people come through, I'm gonna treat them really nice, and then I'm gonna send them packing.
At the next immunity challenge, Whitney from the old Savai hung on for a win.
Whitney wins immunity is safe at tonight's tribal council.
Back at camp, after previously going against his alliance and targeting Edna, Albert again tried to take control by targeting Dawn.
So I'm thinking Dawn wins it.
Albert, he's getting nervous. He's thinking a lot right now about switching up the game.
But at tribal council, Albert's plan was rejected by Coach and the rest of the old Upolu tribe.
Jim, tribe has spoken.
Jim was sent to Redemption Island. And now, with seven remaining in the Upolu alliance, the question is, will anyone seize the opportunity to team up with Don and Whitney and turn the game upside down? Previously on Survivor. Since day one, Coach has been the driving force behind an impenetrable alliance of five.
You've got Rick, Brandon, Sophie, Albert, and you've got myself.
And he added Edna as a sixth.
I can't lie to anybody anymore.
But Brandon shattered any illusions that Edna had about moving up in the pecking order.
Brandon said that the other five people in the alliance have basically just tolerated me.
We are merged.
Yes!
After the two tribes merged, they were dead even.
At this point, it's a deadlock 6-6 vote.
You are the most powerful man in the game.
But Coach somehow convinced Cochrane to jump from sixth at the old Savai to Seven in his alliance.
Who is the strongest? Strongest man on earth, they called him.
Hercules?
Yep.
Absolutely. Hercules?
I've convinced Cochrane that he will be the man of the match.
Keith, tribe has spoken.
With the numbers advantage, the old Upolu tribe picked off the old Savai'i tribe one by one.
Whitney, the tribe has spoken.
Leaving Ozzy, Dawn, and Whitney at Redemption Island.
Oh, man.
Waiting to battle it out for a shot at returning to the game.
The good news is the seven of you have accomplished your goal. The bad news, nowhere left to hide. This game is about to change.
Previously on Survivor. At the Upolu tribe,
there was five of us that were sitting out by the canoe.
A random conversation on the first night turned into a final five pack.
The four people sitting here with me are the four people that I've gotten the best vibe from.
Later, Coach added Edna to the group as a sixth.
It's my job to protect her.
After the merge, when the alliance of six was in danger,
there's a line in the sand. Come across that line.
Coach persuaded Cochrane to flip and join his alliance as their seven.
I've gotten Cochrane on our side to play the rest of this game. I've convinced him that he will be valued and loved over here.
But on day 29, when he was on the chopping block, Cochrane used all the tricks he learned at Harvard Law to make a final summation.
And he said, I know a lot of you feel indebted to me. I don't feel indebted to you. You know, screw you.
At tribal council, once again, Brandon put his foot in his mouth.
But everybody here knows what's going to happen with these two. Tonight, I'm voting out Cochrane, and then the next night, my vote is for Edna.
He infuriated his allies by publicly revealing their plans.
Cochrane, tribe has spoken.
Now Cochrane heads to Redemption Island, and Edna has to figure out a way to stay in the game. Previously on Survivor. For the past 31 days, Albert and Brandon were part of an alliance of five.
It's Coach, Sophie, Rick, Brandon, and myself.
Plus one, with Edna being the plus one. But during that time, Albert consistently attempted to change the pecking order.
I'm entertaining the idea of running a coup.
Including trying to oust Rick.
But I won't bat an eyelash. I don't like Rick. I don't want to keep Rick here another day.
Albert's antics were starting to annoy his allies.
Albert thinks he has this great strategic mind, and I don't think he's come up with one good plan yet.
Meanwhile, Brandon was also infuriating the tribe.
Brandon's so truthful, he sticks his smelly foot in his mouth and gets in trouble.
Stop. Look at me. Dude, look at me.
I'm worried that he's going to kick over the kettle at the most inopportune time.
And then when the loved ones arrived, Brandon's father did it too.
You're gonna have to keep him under control.
Brandon's dad comes out here and basically tries to bully me into making sure that his son goes all the way to the end and wins $1 million.
You know that he's dangerous in the end game.
With her head on the chopping block, Edna pulled out all the stops to change the vote to Brandon.
And I ask you to define what honor integrity is. Does it include all these emotional outbreaks?
And Albert considered it.
Edna makes some really good points.
But at tribal council, Albert and the rest of the original five hung together.
Edna, the tribe has spoken.
Now, Edna is off to Redemption Island, where Ozzy lies in wait.
Well, from the beginning, you've said it would be the five of you. Now what?
Despite his bargaining with Coach, Cochrane was sent packing.
See you, Cochrane.
Jeez.
Just take the steps.
Yeah.
As was Edna, leaving the original alliance of five formed on night one to finally turn on each other.
That is
Don't
not
you
true.
Lie to me.
That is not true.
Move.
That is not
Ooh.
True. In the game.
Listen, we want to finish.
No, because
where is your strategic mind now?
We take out Sophie next.
I'm feeling like Albert should go home tonight.
Coach will not vote for me.
Brandon, by the way, you're going home tonight.
I want to give my immunity necklace up.
Thinking he was safe, Brandon gave up his immunity to protect Albert.
Honestly, I don't think he's going home tonight, so I'm not going to give him the necklace back.
Brandon, tribe has spoken. You will have a chance to get back in this game. Grab your torch, head to Redemption Island. All right, here's where things stand. The four of you will witness the final duel between Ozzy and Brandon. The winner of the duel will re-enter the game, and the five of you will duke it out.
Tonight, six are left standing.
Come on.
Brandon is out of the duel and out of the game. Ozzy stays alive and is back in this game with a shot at the $1 million. Ozzy wins immunity.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
You are 16th person voted out of Survivor South Pacific.
Rick, need to bring me a torch.
Oh, Rick, come on.
Deep. Have a seat, man. Okay.
Rick, Travis spoken. Time for you to go.
One piece left. Coach turns to watch now. Ozzy still fighting. Sophie wins final immunity. Sophie, three times individual immunity in this game. This is the biggest. This guarantees you a spot at the final tribal council. 17th person voted out of Survivor South Pacific and the 9th and final member of our jury. Ozzy, need to bring your torch.
Sayonara, Survivor. Man, I had a good ride. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys, so much. Third time's a charm, baby.
Ozzy, Travis spoken. Time for you to go.
Well, it's great. Thanks a lot for the chance.
Champagne.
Oh,
look how many eggs we got.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Come here, guys. I need a hug.
You're each going to get a chance to make an opening statement. Then the jury will get their first chance to address you, and then we will vote. Albert, you're up.
The beauty of Survivor and what I love about this adventure is that if you look at the game in its truest essence, this is a social experiment. And that's the part that I really loved and appreciated about this game, is the people that I was surrounded with, the people I got an opportunity to meet. To me, this is not a game about chess pieces, it's a game about people. And I think a higher power really brought everyone sitting here tonight together.
Coach.
I just gotta say, wow, I mean, I really can't believe I'm up here. When you look at the beginning of this game, Redemption Island is built for somebody like Ozzy, you know, because, you know, he's great in challenges and, you know, Coach is a bit of a character. I had an uphill battle coming into this game, and the first time I played this game, I played with arrogance and self-righteousness, and I tried to do something different this game, and that is I tried to lead with compassion, love, appreciation, and respect.
Sophie, you're up.
Okay, so I'm just gonna cut to the chase. It's honor buffs. It's about outwitting, outlasting, and outplaying. And when it comes to outplaying, I felt like I held my own in challenges. When it came to individual immunity, I won 3 individual immunities. When it came to outwitting, I definitely felt like there were 2 parts to it. And one was the strategic part, and I felt like I did that well. I made a 5-person alliance from the beginning, and I wanted to keep that 5-person alliance to the end. And then the other half of outwitting, I think, was the social game, and I think it became more clear to me a couple tribals ago that maybe I wasn't so good at the social game. I felt like I made some genuine friendships back at Upolu. I do think I was honest as possible, so I think I filled the requirements.
Albert, Coach, Sophie, congratulations. Jury, thank you. I will see all of you back in Los Angeles for the reading of the votes. 4 votes, Sophie. 3 votes, Coach. The winner of Survivor South Pacific, Sophie.
Yeah.